Do you remember the quote, to infinity and beyond? Well, how can you go beyond infinity? And what's the opposite of infinity? I'm about to jump in an elevator and find out. You're going to try and teach me some maths, and I'm not the best with numbers, so I think you might have your work cut out for you.
Everyone's great with numbers, they just don't realise they're good with numbers yet. Or no one's talked to them about numbers in a way that makes sense to them.
Don't disappoint me. Let's go. Okay, so what is infinity?
Okay, so infinity, as you said, is this concept that we use to describe something that doesn't have a bound. Right, so if we think of the natural numbers, which are just the counting numbers, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc., it's something bigger than that.
Naturally.
So it's not actually a number, but it's something that
a
number can tend towards. So nothing ever reaches infinity, it just can get closer to infinity.
So how is infinity useful to us?
So, I mean, for me, I work with lots of different systems that change with time. So I like to look at what happens to something as time moves into the future, right? So if I have like a pond of fish and I want to know like what is there something that's going to limit that population of fish? So maybe there's not enough food, not enough space. So I want to look at what happens in the future. Like, do I pick 5 years in the future? Do I pick 10 years in the future? It's all kind of arbitrary. If I look at what happens in that system as t tends to infinity, then I'm going to see maybe some kind of limiting behavior, like the fish is going to reach a population, it's going to blow up, whatever. So we use it to describe something.
Okay, so it sets the point so far that it always allows you to find the limit.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
What's the opposite of infinity?
It depends. So, if I'm talking about infinity as a concept of being unbounded, the opposite would be something that's finite. If I'm talking about time into the future, it would be time in the past.
So it just depends on what it is.
It depends on the context. For sure. And so, you know, it'd be an infinite amount of time in the past. But then if I've got something like infinitely big, it would be something infinitesimally small. So think about
it. Well, let me just stop you there, because we're halfway up through. And I have a lot of questions about infinitesimally small.
Yeah, it's not a great word to say.
No, it's not. And it's not a great concept to think about, if I'm being honest, because how can something be infinitesimally small?
Well, okay, so actually in reality, like, it's quite hard for it to be, but mathematically it's very easy for it to be. So if I've got like a radioactive substance and I'm talking about its half-life, so the amount of time it takes for the quantity of radioactive substance to halve.
Yeah.
Right, so after one half-life, it will halve. After another one, it will halve, and it will halve, and it will halve, and it will halve. So it will never actually reach zero, because I'm still halving something that's not zero.
So it's just like so many decimal places now.
Yeah. But in reality, like, eventually you're going to get to that last, like, atom, and it's going to decay, and there'll be nothing there.
Yeah.
So that's sort of mathematically something can be infinitesimally small. In reality, like, you sort of do hit zero.
Would we ever go that far, or is it just so that we don't have a limit on things and we can kind of find the limit?
Yeah, so it's the mathematical equations that give you this behavior as time goes to infinity, but in reality, like, there's the smallest kind of subatomic particle and we can't get smaller than that.
So infinity is kind of like a tool to let us find the limits.
It's a tool. That's exactly it. It's a really big tool.
Really big, or really, really tiny.
Or a tiny tool, yeah.
Awesome, I think I nailed it.
Yeah, I reckon you did too.
Thank you.
No worries.
When you think about it, infinity is a term that gets used casually quite a lot, and that starts to kind of dilute what it means to us, and we don't think about it as deeply. So it's really interesting to kind of deep dive into what infinity actually means, and to realize that as humans, we're used to applying our physical understanding of the world onto pretty much everything. So when you do that and you say infinity is something that means that there is no bounds, it kind of doesn't make sense. We don't understand how that can be, because there's always physical bounds. But when you reframe it as a mathematical concept or a tool, it makes a lot of sense. It's something that we can use to find those physical limits that we're used to. And I really like knowing that. It's cool to be able to reframe and realize that I think of things in terms of human physicality when that doesn't always need to apply. You know, infinity is just kind of a way of life. if you want to see more stuff from us, we will have a video for you next week. You can hit the subscribe button so you know when that is all ready for you. If you have an idea that you would love explained to you, also pop that in the comments below, and I will go find an expert who can explain it to me so that I can explain it back to you. See you next time.